Energy, frequency, and vibration are intricately woven threads, creating a symphony of existence that resonates through every particle of our reality. This dynamic trio holds the keys to understanding the fundamental nature of our reality, and in turn, our own lives. Nikola Tesla, a renowned inventor, engineer, physicist, the inventor of the alternating current AC electrical systems, and numerous other innovations once said, "If you want to find the secrets of the universe, think in terms of energy, frequency, and vibration." Tesla was deeply interested in understanding the underlying principles of our reality, beyond what was observable to the naked eye. Tesla recognized that everything in this world is comprised of energy, frequency, and vibration. They are the driving force behind all phenomena. Let's break down the key concepts in his statement. Energy, the essence of existence. Energy manifests in various forms, constantly transforming and transmuting. According to the law of conservation of energy, energy cannot be created nor destroyed, only converted from one form to another. This eternal flow of energy is the heartbeat of all life, sustaining the delicate balance of existence. If everything is made of energy, and energy is neither created or destroyed, then all things already exist in an energetic and vibrational state. Understanding this truth is the secret to life's greatest manifestations. In reality, we are not this body which is mortal. We are metaphysical light energy. It is very subtle, immortal, eternal, and cannot be seen with our eyes or by a microscope. Here is an interesting fact. The heart is an electrical organ, producing the strongest source of rhythmic bioelectricity. This energy goes to every cell in your body. Your heart produces enough electrical energy to create a magnetic field, surrounding your body in 360 degrees, measurable about 3 feet outside your body. The human body operates on electrical impulses, and the heart in particular relies on a well-coordinated electrical system to regulate its rhythm. During a heart attack, the normal electrical conduction in the heart may be disrupted, and that's why medics revive us with a defibrillator that delivers an electric shock to the heart, aiming to restore its normal rhythm. Your heart is your battery. We are ethereal beings. We have a bioelectrical aura known as chi or prana. We are electrical, and our atoms are surrounded by electrons, electricity. Next, we have frequency, the language of waves. Tesla was particularly fascinated by the concept of frequency. In the context of electromagnetic waves and oscillations, frequency refers to the number of cycles per unit of time. In the realm of waves, frequency determines the pitch of sound, the color of light, and even the vibrational patterns that shape matter. The concept of frequency extends beyond our sensory perception, resonating through the fabric of reality at both macro and micro scales. Everything, from the cosmic hum of the universe to the subtle vibrations of subatomic particles, communicates through the language of frequency. The electromagnetic spectrum is the range of all frequencies of electromagnetic radiation, which includes everything from the lowest frequencies used for radio communication to the highest frequencies used for gamma rays. Electromagnetic radiation consists of oscillating electric and magnetic fields that propagate through space at the speed of light. Understanding the electromagnetic spectrum is crucial for various scientific, medical, and technological applications. Tesla's work on alternating current involved manipulating the frequency of electrical currents. He believed that understanding and harnessing different frequencies could unlock new possibilities and insights. Everything in every one of us is made of energy that communicates through frequency and vibration. When things vibrate, they create sound waves, which we hear as sounds, words, or music frequencies. Music can literally be the language of the universe. We could feel it. Sound travels in wave frequencies, and those wave frequencies touch and reach everything in the universe, including our souls. To be in touch with this music, you have to be in tune to its frequency. The rhythm of all is found in all. Sound affects the way you feel. You know what effect certain pieces of music could have on you. What emotions they can invoke. The way you feel when your favorite song is playing. Well, that is what I mean. Did you know that the music you are hearing is being played all over again on a perfect little musical instrument inside your ear? We think of sound being produced by the piano, and of course in one sense it is. But in reality, the piano is silent and is merely producing vibrations in the air. As the piano keys are struck, felt hammers strike the strings, causing them to vibrate, each at its own frequency. The vibrating strings set the air pulsating to the same frequencies. These pulsations are transmitted to the outer ear, down the auditory canal, and through the mechanical linkage of the middle ear to the cochlea, which is all rolled up like a cockle shell. If the cochlea could be stretched out, we would discover a musical instrument similar to the piano, but far more wonderful and complex. The ear has more than 24,000 strings. When the piano is played, the ear's remarkable little keyboard plays the same tones and sends corresponding signals along individual lines to the brain. Next, we have vibration, the rhythmic dance of particles. Vibration is the oscillation or back and forth movement of particles, creating waves that propagate through space. In essence, it is the physical expression of frequency. Examples of vibrations include the vibration of a tuning fork, the swinging of a pendulum, and the oscillation of a radio's loudspeaker. Tesla explored the idea that everything in our reality has a vibrational frequency. This notion extends beyond the physical realm into metaphysical and philosophical concepts, suggesting that everything in our reality is in a constant state of vibration. Every object, living or inanimate, possesses a unique vibrational signature. We could get a sense of someone's vibration, and we usually describe it as, "I'm getting a good or bad vibe from this person or situation." In essence, Tesla believed that by understanding and manipulating these fundamental aspects, energy, frequency, and vibration, one can gain deeper insights into the mysteries of the universe. And finally, the taboo topic of aether energy. Aether is considered a universal medium consisting of a primary substance attenuated beyond conception, which fills all space and connects all matter. This medium, or field of force, is responsible for action at a distance, a concept where an object can interact with other objects even though they are separated in space. This idea still baffles today's physicists, but was understood by Nikola Tesla long before Albert Einstein. There have been many claims and theories made by alchemists, philosophers, and real scientists, such as Nikola Tesla, Heinrich Hertz, and Dayton Miller, that confirmed the aether's existence. In Plato's Timaeus, speaking on the topic of air, Plato mentions that there is the most translucent kind, which is called by the name of aether. Aether is described as being a unique essence of life force energy that flows through the universe and most of existence. The source of quintessence, chi, aura, and mana. It is the mystical celestial element that is also known as the fifth element itself. Fire, water, air, earth, and aether. One claim is that aether is the pure essence that the mythological gods lived and breathed in the same way humans did with air. Another claim is that the aether is a force used by God himself to create the universe. According to the Kabbalion, there are at least three levels of both matter and energy, each with aether in the middle. Energy and spirit, Energy vibrates, known as the principle of vibration. All energy moves, vibrates, and spirals. The differences between different manifestations of matter, form, energy, mind, and spirit are the result of different degrees of vibration. Levels and layers. There are three basic planes of being: the great physical plane, earth; the great mental plane, air, fire, water, and earth; the great spiritual plane, ether. Spirits are believed to be ethereal beings that are basically made of ether. The first level consists of the common forms such as heat and light. The second level consists of nature's finer forces, higher forms of energy that is undiscovered by scientists.
Where does that light come from?
But it isn't light.
It's dust.
What's dust?
The third level consists of energy that is unrecognizable by human beings and available only to beings of the spiritual plane. This form of energy can be considered as the divine power, with the users being considered gods. What did Tesla know about ether energy? Ether is the medium for every electromagnetic wave, from radio waves to gamma rays. Only the existence of a field of force can account for the motions of bodies as observed, and its assumption dispenses with space curvature. All literature on this subject is futile and destined to oblivion. So are all the attempts to explain the workings of the universe without recognizing the existence of ether and the indispensable function it plays in the phenomena. Nikola Tesla. Tesla declared that light and other electromagnetic waves are not transverse waves, a theory still believed today in conventional physics, but instead are a longitudinal disturbance in the ether, involving alternate compressions and rarefactions. In his own words, light could be nothing else than a sound wave in the ether. Since light has such a constancy of velocity, light can only be explained by assuming that light is dependent solely on the physical properties of the medium, especially density and elastic force. Believing that the ether was one of the most important results of modern scientific research, Tesla refused to abandon it because in his mind, the ether was an important key to understanding how electrical energy could travel through space without wires. In 1896, Tesla finally obtained proof of the ether. He invented a new form of vacuum tube which could be charged to any high potential and operated with pressures up to 4 million volts. In 1929, Tesla spoke of these vacuum tubes, saying, "One of the first striking observations made with my tubes was that a purplish glow for several feet around the end of the tube was formed, and I readily ascertained that it was due to the escape of the charges of the particles as soon as they passed out into the air, for it was only in a nearly perfect vacuum that these changes could be confined to them." The coronal discharge proved that there must be a medium besides air in the space, composed of particles immeasurably smaller than those of air, as otherwise, such a discharge would not be possible. In summary, Tesla experimented and proved his theories using the scientific method. His methods were far more superior to other physicists of his time because he had the mortars and transformers invented by himself to help him with his experiments. In the future, the ether may be referred to as dark matter, or the force, etc., but Nikola Tesla's ether theory will be proven true in years to come. When Tesla died in 1943, the FBI, led by Donald Trump's uncle, John G. Trump, banned and seized all his work, in particular, the work involving the use of ether energy. His research on ether energy has been declared as secret records by the United States government. But truth has a funny way of resurfacing. We have an abundance of energy, and it should be free to every living human on Earth. But unfortunately, just how Big Pharma monopolized the medical industry, the energy industry has also been monopolized, and that is the reason why we don't have free energy today. Conclusion: energy, frequency, vibration, and ether form the symphony of the universe, orchestrating the dance of life and the flow of existence. As we strive to unravel the secrets of our reality, understanding and harnessing the power of energy frequency, vibration, and ether can lead to more profound insights and transform our world to a glorious golden age. Whether through scientific inquiry or spiritual exploration, understanding this power can open doors to a deeper comprehension of the world we live in. In spirituality, ancient traditions and modern practices alike emphasize the importance of aligning one's energy to achieve inner balance, peace, and spiritual growth. Nikola Tesla once said, "The day science begins to study non-physical phenomena, it will make more progress in one decade than all of the previous centuries of its existence." Today's scientists have substituted mathematics for experiments, and they wander off through equation after equation and eventually build a structure which has no relation to reality. Nikola Tesla.